Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Ibrahim, وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَعِيلُ. Ibrahim and Ismail were revealing it. Because Allah said, يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ. يَرْفَعُ الْقَوَاعِدَ means they were already there. There was a building, and it is said that the flood of Nuh alayhi salam destroyed it. But the flood of Nuh alayhi salam destroyed it. So when Ibrahim came to Mecca, Allah ordered him through Jibreel alayhi salam to rebuild it along his son Ismail. And Ismail alayhi salam used to hand over to his father stones, and wherever they put it, they say, رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. With each brick they put, they were saying this dua. How many of us say this dua when we do something good? Some of us never have asked Allah to accept. What guarantees that your salat of Maghrib and this dars and whatever we do good is accepted? So follow every good deed, my brothers and sisters. Everything you do good, fasting, salat, siyam, zakat, teaching, learning, whatever you do, say, رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا يَا مَوْلَانَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. Ask Allah acceptance and tawbah. What do we do after the taslim? When we say, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله, what do we say? Astaghfir. Why do you have to make istighfar? After every ibadah, you must say istighfar. Because maybe something was committed during that ibadah that nullifies it, times zero. Million times zero for what?
Zero.
You just had a million, but you times it zero. Shaytan, when it comes inside the salat, or when you are donating zakat, or when you are teaching, or when you are learning, whatever, and then nullifies everything. So ask Allah to accept, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us tawbah and maghfirah. Ameen. So we learn from Ibrahim alayhi salam and his son, when they were rebuilding the Kaaba, they were asking Allah with each brick they put to accept and forgive them. This is something we learn from Ibrahim alayhi salam and his son Ismail alayhi salam. So the Kaaba from day one was a house that people were praying inside it. But because the number of believers grew up, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed even the land, the Haram. It's called the Haram. The Haram is a campus. A campus. So it's not just the house that is blessed, but also the land, as well as Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa, which many of us have forgotten about. Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa is not just the land that is in it. Even the Al-Ard Al-Muqaddasa, التي باركنا حولها, the land that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed around. So, as Muslims, we know that the Kaaba is very important because Allah made it sacred. So we don't worship it. We worship Allah who told us to face that place, that's all. We face it. We don't go there like some people do, start throwing there. I was in Hajj and you see some people taking part of their ihram and trying to touch the Kaaba. And then they say, well, part of our cloth has touched the Kaaba. You see some people putting their faces on the wall. You see some people holding the Kaaba, I mean the sitar al-Kaaba. Brothers, Allahu Akbar. That Kaaba is not sacred by itself. And nothing in it is sacred by itself, except when Allah said so. Meaning, whether you touch it or not, as long as you go and do Hajj or Umrah or face your face, turn your face towards it, you are inshallah okay. And you see people almost killing each other or killing other brothers or sisters to touch it. And what did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say to prove that the Kaaba by itself is not that sacred unless Allah made it sacred? He said, لا زوال الكعبة أهون عند الله من قتل امرئ مسلم. Hadith Bukhari Muslim. Nabi alayhi salam said, if this Kaaba is destroyed many, many times, it's easy than killing one innocent. So the blood of a Muslim is holier than the Kaaba. The blood of a Muslim is holier than the Kaaba. Simply because the Kaaba, you can always rebuild it. And the Kaaba has been rebuilt 5 times in history. 5 times. We'll see them inshallah. Through that, this durus. It has been rebuilt 5 times. But when you kill an innocent life, what happens? Very, really bad. You can't. لزوال الكعبة أهمل عند الله من قتل امرئ مسلم. With this, my brothers, I hope I have explained that the Kaaba by itself is not sacred only when Allah made it sacred, only when Allah told us to face the Kaaba and pray towards it. Abu Dharr al-Ghifari, may Allah be pleased with him, said, سألت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عن أول مسجد وضع في الأرض. I asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, what was the first house that was put on earth for people to worship Allah? قال عليه الصلاة والسلام المسجد الحرام. المسجد الحرام. In Mecca. ثم قلت ثم علي. Then I said, Abu Dharr al-Ghifari continues, then what? What else? He said, المسجد الأقصى. Remember, brothers, المسجد الأقصى is an amana in our necks. Each one of us will be asked about it يوم القيامة. By the way, one of the questions Allah will ask us يوم القيامة, what have you done to one of my masajid that were occupied? What were you? You keep, look, bring any excuse. Allah will never accept it. Oh, I was in Houston, I was that far. No, He will say, you could have at least spoken about it, educate people about it. Make dua to those Muslims who are murabitin. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be with them and give them victory. Say amen. I don't know how we the Muslims can sleep, brothers, when a masjid is occupied. I don't understand. I don't understand. How can you sleep if your home is under siege? If your house? So at least we have to feel it. At least feel it. Because if we don't feel it, that means we are dead, wa'iyad billah. And Allah, yawm al-qiyam, will ask us, what have you done for Masjid al-Aqsa? Ya Rab, I was reminding people about it. I was talking about it. I was making khutbah about it. I was making dua in the khutbah to those Muslims who are living there. That's the least I could have done. And today, we don't even teach our children about the history of Palestine, because Palestine to us has become what? A national issue. It's not a national, it's an Islamic issue. 1.7 billion Muslims will be asked about it Yom Al-Qiyam. I repeat, 1.7 as of today, 2010. And this is not politics, this is your deen. سُبْحَانَ الَّذِي أَسْرَى بِعَبْدِهِ لَيْلًا مِنَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ إِلَى وَهِ إِلَى الْيُسْرِ إِلَى الْمَسْجِدِ الْأَقْصَى الَّذِي بَارَكْنَا حَوْلًا لِنُرِيَهُ مِنْ آيَاتِنَا. Why must I ask this? And each one of us will be asked according to his position in society. A president, a king, according to his level. A cook or a janitor, according to his level. You don't say, no, Allah will not ask me. And it's not the issue of the Arabs only, it's the issue of every Muslim who says La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. Remember that, my brothers. So, Abu Dharr al-Ghifari asked, and then what? What was the second masjid? He said, Al-Masjid al-Aqsa. قلت كم بينهما? How long? What was the time difference between putting the Masjid al-Haram in Mecca and the Masjid al-Aqsa in Jerusalem? قال عليه الصلاة والسلام 40 عاما 40 years. And who built them? It is said that Adam عليه السلام built both masajid. A masjid in Mecca, which is the Kaaba, and another masjid in Masjid al-Aqsa. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said something else to Abu Dharr, which is so great for all of us, the Muslims. And it is actually this thing that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم spoke about, is the reason for many, many people to embrace Islam. What is it? He said, ثُمَّ الْأَرْضُ لَكَ مَسْجِدًا فَحَيْثُمَا أَدْرَكَتْكَ الصَّلَاةَ فَصَلِّي فَإِنَّ الْفَضْلَ فِيهَا. Nabi عليه الصلاة والسلام added something to the question of Abu Dharr al-Ghifari, may Allah be pleased with him, who was a reason, by the way, for us to learn this. He said, then the earth has been made a masjid. Wherever you might be, just pray. This is very practical. Many Japanese are embracing Islam because, you know, Japanese, unlike Muslims, they are not lazy, they work. Out of 8 hours, they work 7 hours, they produce 7 hours. The Muslims of today, out of 8 hours, they may work 1 hour. 7 hours between argila and tea and newspaper and qilm al-qal and kathrat al-su'al. You know why you are not productive? So those Japanese people, oh, I can pray anywhere? Yes, you can pray anywhere. Unlike other religions, your prayer might not be accepted unless you pray in a certain place. Alhamdulillah, Allah didn't put that burden on us.